My name is Rick Grimes. I own a company called Southwest Irrigation in Southwest Arizona. I am a mechanical sprinkler dealer, and I've been in this business for right at 40 years. I cover most of the state of Arizona and parts of Imperial Valley, California. We would average almost 60, 65 degrees year round. In June, July, and August, it can get up to 118, 120 degrees. Wind in the spring like it is right now for probably 3 months. Predominantly alfalfa, sugar beets. In June, July, and August, you'll see ET rates in this part of the state, 6/10 to 7/10 of an inch a day. So when these machines are designed, I design them for June, July, and August and really don't worry about the other 9 months. This is about 5,000 acres. They have 33 half-mile centerfeed linears and probably a half dozen pivots on this farm. You get a little further from here, there's 16 pivot farms, 10 pivot farms. Some guys buy one or two. A lot of them are money investors that are coming into the area to get into the farming business. Some areas sandy loam, some areas pretty clay like it is on this farm right here. Most farms in this state were set up for flood irrigation, so the fields were all laser leveled. So when they do change over to mechanical from that, the fields are already flat. So we don't have any rolling hills really in this part of the state. It's all pretty flat. On a linear field where a machine is getting 320 acres, you're looking at a minimum on the water flow of 10 gallons a minute per acre, and that number has risen up to 12 gallons a minute per acre. And that's just to offset the ET rates in June, July, and August. We use a lot of close spacing in this area. Probably 99% of everything that I sell with sprinklers is close spacing, and I mean 30 inch and probably no wider than 60 inch. The average height is I like to do it at 2 feet off the ground. Some people go 3 feet off the ground depending on the crop that they have. The reason I started doing close spacing, I've been doing this for close spacing probably 25 years. The whole idea behind that was to get the pumping costs down and the sprinkler closer to the ground where you could actually less horsepower, less pressure to do the same thing that you used to do with a sprinkler that's 4, 5, 6 feet off the ground and 10 foot apart. That was kind of the whole idea behind it. Water application, energy savings. The whole idea with 30 inch spacing is if you take a guy that's pumping 1,000 gallons a minute on his pivot for 120 acres, and he's got sprinklers that are 10 feet apart and they're 4 or 5 feet off the ground, if you change that over to close spacing, lower that sprinkler down to the ground where you're putting more water onto the ground, 30-inch spacing will come out traditionally between 98 and 99% uniformity and distribution on water applied. You can't get that with a sprinkler that's 10 feet apart and 5 feet off the ground. In Arizona, on mechanical irrigation, on pivots or linears, we get 6,000 hours a year out here in the state because we farm 12 months out of the year. Because of the heavy soil that we have in the state of Arizona, when you have a sprinkler that's 10 feet apart, what we have to do down here is we try to keep the wheel track dry, whether it is on a linear or a pivot. So with a closer spacing allows us to do that, because if you have a sprinkler on there that's spraying a 50-foot diameter, you cannot keep the wheel track dry. So we keep the wheel track dry with the close spacing. It makes it a plus, and you have to do that in this area. Otherwise, your machines are going to be stuck all the time. And allows them to also irrigate more acres as you're saving money, because you're able to put more water on the ground and get a better uniform crop with it. I think with 30 inch spacing, and I don't know what the yield increase would be over a wide space sprinkler, that would be up to the grower to let you know that number, but you're putting more water on the ground, you're putting it more efficient on the ground. So basically you're not irrigating your field as much as you would with a sprinkler that is 10 feet apart, 20 feet apart, 30 feet apart. Yes, 99% of everything that I sell is close spacing, but when I go out to a customer who wants to put in a new system, pretty much have to talk to him and ask him what he's looking for. He pretty much dictates the kind of package that will go on that machine. You know, like you're looking at vegetable crops with a light application that takes a different kind of a spray plate than, say, this corn crop would right here, or a hay crop. I could take you back to the first sprinkler in Barstow, California, and it's still running today. We actually take the spray plate off and drill the water straight into the ground. See, out here the problem is that when they drill the water into the ground is so heavy, after they harvest their crop, they go across it 3 or 4 or 5 times with tractors, and it seals the ground off. So traditionally, you'd have to make a couple revolutions with your pivot or your linear to get the ground loose enough to start taking the water. When you drill that into the ground, it starts taking the water right now. And the regrowth is where you'll see the difference in the regrowth. In my territory, I am predominantly Senninger products. They make a wide range of products. They have a pretty good group of spray plates to work with. I'm a big IWAB fan. Farmers like the IWAB. Their regulators are definitely, I think, top-notch, first thing in the market. Just the overall product line, whether it be the IWAB, whether it be the UP3 sprinkler, the spray plates, I just feel that they have an overall better line.